In this video, I'm going to show you how to take apart and fix a couple things on the LG G4, one of LG's newest smartphones, coming out in 2015. This one has the leather back with the center stitching. Go ahead and turn off the phone first, remove the back cover, pop out the battery, and then you're left with 11 screws to take off from the back housing. And then I found that it's easier to grab along the center of the battery hole and the edge of the phone to start pulling away that back plastic plate. And you can just unsnap it from the edge of the phone and the whole thing will just come loose once all those screws are out. Pretty straightforward. This phone is actually pretty darn easy to take apart. Nothing's glued down or adhesive like the Galaxy S6. You can see these little gold contact pads that just kind of rest on top of the motherboard. That's how the power button and the volume buttons communicate with the motherboard. The bottom part of the bracket also snaps off. This is how you replace the loudspeaker. You can see the loudspeaker segment in this bottom section and the gold contact plates that also just sit on top of the motherboard. LG's a pretty big fan of those. They always have been. Here is the buttons, the volume buttons and the camera lens. Pretty straightforward and easy to replace. If your camera lens gets scratched or broken, it's pretty easy to pop out and pop in a new one, which is nice, considering that the camera lens is easy to scratch. Here is the buttons ribbon cables. You can just pop those out and replace them with the new one if needed. The ribbon cable for the screen just snaps up like a little Lego piece off of the main board. Be careful with any connections or chips down around on the main board. You don't want to pry up on those when you're lifting off the ribbon cable connections. The motherboard just pulls away from the plastic frame of the screen. And you can see here the contact points that I was talking about earlier. Here's the SIM card slot that is not replaceable, battery connections, and the charging port. Not replaceable either. You can see the back here as well. You might be able to do it if you had some micro soldering tools, but that's beyond the scope of a normal person's capability, so we're going to skip over that. Here's the front-facing camera and the vibrator motor, which is pretty small in my opinion. Usually with phones and even watches, they're a lot bigger than that. Here's the rear-facing camera, 16 megapixels, capable of recording in 4K. It also has the image stabilization chips that you can see on the side of it. Here's the earpiece. I'm going to lift off the little ribbon cable first. It has some more of those contact points that we were talking about earlier. And something else I found interesting is there's these little contact points on the side of the motherboard that just clip in next to the headphone jack. And that's how the headphone jack communicates with the motherboard. So here's the screen. It's the combination of the glass digitizer LCD and plastic frame. If you are going to replace the screen, you have two options. One is to just buy the glass and LCD combo, or buy it with the frame, which usually ends up costing about $10 or $15 more, but will save you hours of work and frustration. So if you're going to do a screen repair, make sure you buy the screen with the frame included. You will thank me later. Put back in all the components, got the vibrator motor, the rear camera, front-facing camera, and the earpiece all placed back in, making sure that it lines up with the little pins on the side. And when you're placing the motherboard back into place, make sure you lift up the ribbon cables of the cameras so they don't get caught underneath the motherboard. There's only three to worry about, so it's not too bad. Then make sure the motherboard slips inside of the plastic clasps at the top and the bottom. Just kind of press it in, you'll hear it click into place to make sure that the motherboard is secure. Then putting the button back together, I put the center button down first, just kind of eyeballing it, and then the top layer just clips down over the top of it. And then press it a couple times, make sure that everything's clicking and you don't have anything stuck underneath there and it's all cleaned out. And try not to touch the inside of the camera lens either if you go to replace that. That'll make it so your pictures are blurry later on. I'm going to clip the back frame back together. The loudspeaker is connecting to the rest of the device, making sure that the ribbon cables for the screen is clamped down to the motherboard. It's kind of like a little tiny, tiny Lego piece. It has a bunch of little fins that just clamp down onto the motherboard. So you have to line it up perfectly and then just clip it down and you'll feel it snap underneath your fingers as it clicks into place. Getting the back housing pressed into the frame of the screen. Getting the battery back in there. And then I'm going to test it before I put the screws back in. Now the back cover is in place. I'm going to go ahead and give the phone a try. And everything works. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments below. Don't forget to like if this video helped you, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks a ton for watching. Hope to see you around.